Let's talk about an important management that's lined up on the show. But before we do that, here's a quick check at the market. PNB Housing is the management. Okay, let's go straight to the management and we'll come back to the markets later. Sanjaya Gupta, the MD of PNB Housing, is joining us. Hi, Mr. Gupta. Thank you so much for coming on board. Well, there's been a decent profit growth this time around. There's been a substantial rise in the gross NPA as well on a sequential basis. Can you tell us what led to this kind of performance?
Well, the prime reason is that one is that it's an environment where the consumer sentiment is down and hence the growth rates are down. But, you know, let me be very candid, I'm not so much concerned because our retail disbursement actually grew by about 7% year on year, and I'm very sure that during the entire year, the retail loans are going to be, the cornerstone of our concentration. And the corporate disbursements or the corporate finance disbursements degrew by about 82%. And we are just honoring our past commitments where the projects are under construction. And we are not doing any new business as for now. So I'm not very much concerned on the growth. On the profits, yes, the impact of the ECL because of the forward flow of one of our accounts from the five stressed accounts which we disclosed on 31st March 2019 had a ramification because of the provisioning. But I think before the end of the year, we will be resolving these type of corporate finance accounts and we should be coasting very well even on profitability of the company. But you know, having seen the results, I'm not much concerned because even in this environment with a year-on-year profit growth of about 11% and with conservative provisioning for our corporate finance book, I'm pretty satisfied with the performance and I think better times will come during this very financial year.
Good morning, Mr. Gupta. This is Cheryl also joining in. Just wanted to get more color on your asset quality. Your gross NPA saw a sharp rise of nearly 82%. And you have exposure to individual housing, construction finance, as well as non-housing segments. So what is the kind of NPA trends that you are actually seeing in these segments? And also, more importantly, what is your outlook since the external environment is only turning bad now?
Yeah. So, you know, you should also remember that, you know, loans are individual housing loans and they constitute about 62%, and with the forward flow they are at about 0.7 of the portfolio. So that is much below the industry average, about 50-60 bps below the industry average, even if I was to compare it with quarter four of the previous year, because the quarter one numbers of the remaining HFCs have not yet come out. And on the LAP, it is about 0.95, and the industry average there is at about 1.7% as of quarter four of the previous year. On the corporate finance book, we are at about 1.04%, which is again one of the lowest. The industry average, if you want to see in quarter four, is at about 2.5%. So we are far, far lower than the industry averages. Plus, you should also remember that about 12,000 crores of our cherry pick book is securitized. And that has a vintage of about 37 months. And the gross NPAs on that book is only 0.22%. So that really reflects the quality of our acquisition, our underwriting, our servicing, our ability to, you know, resolve NPAs. And that is a larger picture of this company. And I think, you know, this is seasonal. Quarter one always sees forward flows. Yes, the environment this year has been particularly slow and there have been forward flows in the sector. So it has happened with us also, but we are far better. And I'm sure that by the end of quarter three, beginning quarter four, we will start seeing resolutions within this financial year. And once again, PNB Housing will be the best in category before the year ends.
Let's talk about the disbursements performance as well. It's moderated 11% on a quarter-on-quarter basis, and nearly 22% YOY. Do you expect further moderation in disbursements given that the macro situation, the way it's panning out? Also, what's the kind of AUM growth that you're expecting for the rest of the fiscal?
You are very correct and your observation is very sharp. So sequentially, yes, we have degrown. Even quarter one of previous year and quarter one of this year has seen a little bit of degrowth. But the majority of the reason is that, you know, we have slowed down on the corporate finance. So if we have done a disbursement of about 7,600 crores in quarter one, about 7,000 crores is for retail loans, and that has seen a very positive trend in comparison to even the last year or sequentially speaking to quarter four, and that is about 7%, where we have really by design degrown by about 82% is the corporate finance, and that will remain, I think, during this financial year. We are only honoring our past disbursement commitments on the corporate finance, which means past loan sanctions and partly disbursed. We are not acquiring any new accounts on corporate finance, but our focus will continue to be on retail housing loans, retail LAP, and we are seeing a positive trend. 50 out of 104 branches that we have as of today, 50 of our branches are less than 2 years old, and they will come to optimum utilization during this financial year, and they will start pumping in a huge amount of retail business. And I think that is our engine of growth. They are in tier 2, tier 3 cities, and that is where affordable housing or mass housing happens, majorly speaking. So I am not very concerned on the growth rates. Forward-looking statements I will not like to make on AUM growth, but let me tell you that the growth of this company is going to be far superior than the industry average.
All right, sir. Thank you so much for talking to us about your quarter gone by and the way forward. Let's touch base with another earnings candidate.